Brennan Lou's first video production. Why don't you ask him where he was born and that kind of stuff? We'll start from scratch.
Where were you born, Papa?
I was born in Phelps County, north of Funk, where Grandpa and Grandma Borg used to live. I was born in a blizzard. The doctor couldn't even get there. So I had to wait till the next day for the proper procedures.
Wow, so who did the dirty business?
Frieda Anderson was a midwife.
Like in the house, or what?
Where were you born, Papa?
At Grandpa and Grandma's yellow house up on the hill there where the cattle are generally.
So, wasn't in a hospital? Talk about that a little bit. It was in a house?
Yeah, it was just in the bedroom.
Cool, huh? So everything must have went well, even without a doctor.
Well, some people say that's what's wrong with me.
And who are your mom and dad?
Oh, what?
Who are your mom and dad?
Who are your mom and dad?
Oh, who are my mom and dad? Verna Borg and Edgar Borg were my folks' name. So they would be your great grandma and grandma.
Did you have brothers and sisters at that time, or were you the first? Or?
No, I was fifth, I guess.
You had four?
Huh?
You had four brothers and sisters?
Yeah.
Did you get along with them?
Did I get along with them? I guess so, I'm here.
And again, did he fight with them?
Did you fight with them?
Oh, once in a while we had a little ruckus.
Oh, what was your favorite toy?
What was my favorite toy? I believe my steel wheel trucks and stuff that were made for Ford, and then there was a Ford 10 tractor and a disc. So I had pretty good toys.
So big metal ones just like today, except they were trucks and tractors and
smaller version of them.
Cool.
Did you have lots?
Did I have lots of them? Yeah, I had quite a few of them.
Somebody worked on the farm.
Did you work on the farm?
Did I work on the farm? Yes, I started milking cows pretty early, and I milked till way late. I was moving to town when I still was milking.
What was that like? Obviously, you didn't have all the contraptions of today.
No, we had milked them by hand. Just the cows would say, I heard them say one morning when I was coming across the yard with the milk pails, "Oh, here comes old Icy Fingers again."
Did they say that?
Yeah. Heard one of them say to the other.
That's about school, maybe.
What school did you go to?
We went to Little Red Schoolhouse, District Number 6. It was about 2 miles from home.
Did you have a lot of friends?
A lot of fun, yeah. Sometimes we had a lot of fun going to school. Sometimes we piddled along and Vernon didn't make it and throwing things at one another.
Did you have friends?
Did I have friends? Oh, yes, I had friends. They were good friends of the family, too, so Dad and Charlie Eckwell and his wife were the work friends. We did the harvesting and stuff together. And we'd visit them at night. We'd go see each other about once or twice a week, and we always had fun. We'd always try to pick a moonlight night so we could go out around the haystacks and play hide and seek in the moonlight.
That sounds fun.
Yeah.
How many kids were there doing that?
Oh, there was five of us and four of them, I guess.
Wow. Nine kids playing in the moonlight, that's cool. So you didn't just walk to school when it was warm out, I suppose, huh? You had to walk cold and winter and...
Yeah, the folks thought we could make it without getting too cold or too hot, why then we had to walk. It was 2 miles. It was always pretty nice when we got out of school. It was around 4 o'clock. That was a nice time of the day. And then we could always make it home.
Did you go a half a day school or a whole?
Whole day school.
Yes.
What was some of your favorite subjects?
Suits.
I liked arithmetic. Never was too good at English literature or English grammar, how to construct sentences and stuff. I wasn't too hot on that stuff.
And you like
but that? I liked physics and algebra, and I liked I like to sit in the schoolroom and in the back row and figure out the mathematic problems that the teacher would give to the 7th and 8th graders when I was about a 3rd grader. So consequently, I had the highest grade in mental arithmetic than anybody in the school.
What was your favorite food?
What was my favorite food? Can you believe it or not, we had fried egg sandwiches with ketchup on them.
What?
They're good though, huh?
Yes, I still can taste them.
What year was your math award, do you remember?
What was that?
What year did you win the math award or whatever?
Oh, God.
Or about what age?
I think I was about 7th or 8th grader. And I got a picture and I still got it. School teacher liked pictures of trees and brooks and like meadows and stuff. So she bought me a picture for Christmas.
Cool. Yeah. Now, did the school just go to 8th grade, or did you get to high school too, or?
No, it was just 8th, we went from kindergarten, and didn't have to kindergarten many years. There wasn't any small enough kids to go, so we went to, they had a kindergarten class, and then went on up to the 8th grade. And we'd have to go into Holdridge to take an 8th grade examination. That was always a big day.
My school, it goes to...
4th grade.
The 4th.
So you had to show that your teacher knew what she was talking about. I mean, that you learned enough to go to high school?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Who was your teacher?
Yeah, I had several of them.
What was one of them?
One of them was Frances Gerbrandt, I remember her. She always liked to ride on my horse. In the summertime, we herd cattle down towards the Jennings place, and then she'd come out.
You had a horse?
Yeah. We had two of them we could ride.
You want to sit in the chair? Would that be more comfortable?
No, no, this is fine.
Okay.
This is fine.
Yeah. I don't know if you don't have a good back there, but...
Yeah, I think...
What, your teacher would come to your house and ride your horse, or what do you come
up? No, we'd be herding cattle down towards the Jennings, which was more ditches were, would, finally they'd grass over and have grass on them. Otherwise, when they first graded them, it'd be weedy, and cows would keep them picked off pretty good. And she'd come out and want to ride the horses.
What about, did you get a chance to go to high school then? I know a lot of people didn't.
Oh, yeah.
All 4 years and everything?
Yeah. Huh? We all four. All four of us kids born didn't go to high school. Margaret and Kenny and I and LaDonna all went through high school.
Who didn't go?
Who, Warren, our oldest brother. By that time, he went out to California and helped Grandpa Borg out there run a carpet plant.
Huh.
Oh.
Kind of like a furniture store, but mostly they sold carpet.
How did he get out there exactly? I mean, your grandpa, first of all, and then obviously your brother just went because there was a job there.
Yeah. Grandpa found a job for him.
How did your grandpa find the reason to go clear out to California?
Well, he had, he and grandma lived out there for quite a few years.
Have you done this before?
Had I done this before?
Yeah.
What?
What we're doing now, have you ever done this before?
What was that?
Have you ever been interviewed before, I think it's the
question. Oh, I've ever done this before. Well, I've been interviewed before, but not with such a kook for...
What?
Look, this is what he's talking about. See that?
What?
Well, he got to be in a garden magazine. Why don't you ask him about that?
Oh, did you get to be in a garden machine?
This garden magazine had a contest. I was in... Master Gardeners, so she come and she encouraged me to tell about my garden and how I watered it. And
how did you meet?
Let's finish this question first. So how did you, what did, how did you just apply for it and get it, or how'd that work?
Yeah, you sent in, if he was interested, well, then you send in your name and address, and they sent out some pretty good interviewers. They were, most of them were book artists.
How did you?
Authors.
So then you, so you got the big interview, and you didn't even know when they came to interview you whether you could win or not.
No, not sure. That was part of it right there. She.
Yeah.
She took it. She was up on a old rickety ladder that I wouldn't want to get up over the second or third step. She got clear up on top. Stood there, and you can see that's down towards the garden.
Oh, that's how she took your picture.
Yeah.
Oh, I see. Cool, that's pretty cool.
And then she wrote the story up and sent it to me to prove of it.
That's a pretty big day then, I'll bet.
Yeah, that was a big day.
How'd you meet Granny?
What?
How'd you meet Granny?
How'd I meet Granny? I was going to say, Granny made it, this lady that was interviewing me and I dinner out of the garden, green beans and carrots and radishes, tomatoes, what have you.
Did you
I think Brennan's backing you up a few years to how did you meet Granny?
Oh, how did I meet Granny?
The first time, and what were dates like at that time and stuff?
Well, we didn't have much money to spend on gas and going hither and yon, but once in a while we'd get to go to... Minnie lived in Wilcox. Sometimes I'd drive down there and we'd have a day to go to a show or something, and then I'd bring her up to her. She boarded in a room at Butch Silver's place, which is just the first place west of the Emmaus Church. So
you met her in high school then? Or?
No.
No.
No, she was teaching school up there. Oh, I guess I met her a few times before at dances and stuff.
You guys were quite the dancers. I now remember that.
Well, they claimed we were. I always enjoyed it, and so did many. But we weren't so high-stepping classical dancers as far as that goes.
Yes, how about
what was your favorite movie?
What was our favorite movie? We had a favorite movie between the two of us. We call it, what was it? One of Disney's pictures.
What was it about?
We saw several of them. One was about the all the characters, Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs were the ones that we liked. Our favorite song was When You Wish Upon a Star, and that was from that movie.
Oh yeah. What about, you want to sit here and watch, Tim? Okay, come here. We're switching jobs here. Okay. You see him? Is he in there?
Yeah.
Right there? Not there? Is that good? You see him?
Yeah.
So, when did the war come into play with, when you got married, or before you got married, or World War II, right?
Obviously. Yeah, World War II came, we'd planned to get married, and the World War II got to going pretty good. So they sent us a letter. Your friends and neighbors have selected you to go see, fight in the war, which I did. Eventually, I went to my first war experience was with it turned out to be a radar school, and I went down there for basic radio and just radio repair and stuff like that, and went there. After about 10 weeks, they called me in and said they wanted me for an instructor.
You must have knew something how to do it, obviously.
I didn't know what to do. I was always interested in physics and radio and stuff like that, but I never made a practice of using it as a business or anything. But it was a nice
So during the war, what did you actually do then?
Then I taught, after I went through the radio school, and taught there a few weeks. They shipped in Air Corps, bunches of Air Corps. It generally was 23 of them. 22 good guys and a couple of goofballs always.
And you got kept. Was this at a base, or where did you do this at?
Camp Murphy, Florida. Is come in.
Hi, Daryl.
Hello. And it's Brenna's daddy, and he is pretty much occupied by taking interviews and stuff like that for the. Brenna's been on the TV lots of times.
Oh, yeah?
When she was a little girl, she was on it.
Yeah, you can't take it with you anyway, right?
That's right.
Well, I think we're still in the war at this point. So did you stay in the States the whole time then?
Or did you I taught radar for about 4.5 years, 4.5, 5 years. And then I kept nagging at him while we was getting. We was getting more technicians than we could use, and the war finally dwindled down for us. Luftwaffe was the radar is what defeated them, and then they sent us to various places because we, depending on what we are. We did for work. They sent me back to the infantry and got into the cavalry.
And who was your favorite friend?
Who was my favorite what?
Who was your favorite friend in the war?
Oh, I would say maybe Carl Dahlstrom. He was a little older, and he was a single fella, and he was from can I name the name?
He's from around here, though, right?
Or? No, from East Coast.
Oh.
And then there was another fellow from West Virginia, and his wife got to be friends of ours. You know, I haven't got up guts enough to tell them that Minnie died. Is that terrible?
Well, it's hard to keep track of somebody that long ago. That's a lot of years ago.
But we always communicated at Christmas time, always.
I miss Grandma.
You miss Grandma? Well, Grandpa does too. She's a good lady.
Did you get married after the war or before the war then?
Just before the war.
Just before the war, okay.
We got married on March 1st. When did you expect a farmer to start his business? March 1st.
Did Grandma have any kids?
Did Grandma have any kids? Uncle Kenny's my brother. Do you know him?
And that, she's talking about Granny. Oh. Granny's kids. Tom and Carl. That
oh.
Different Grandma. She's talking about Granny.
Oh.
Right?
Who did you mean, honey?
Did Granny have any kids? Is that what you meant?
Yeah, Aunt Margaret is my sister. Do you know her?
Yeah. Aunt Margaret.
And Aunt LaDonna is his sister, or is my sister.
Uh-huh. He's talking about his brothers and sisters.
And Warren is the oldest one. He passed away here this last summer.
Oh, that's too bad.
How about let's get you married first? What was the wedding like, and where did you have it? And was it a big deal, or was it not that fancy those days?
Nothing fancy. We just we went to the minister, and he suggested that we have it there in the parsonage. And so we did.
So you got married in the pastor's house?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Who would be the people that would be there? It's a select group, obviously.
Ivan, Benny's brother, was the best man, and a friend of Ivan's was the bridesmaid, a gal from California. There was a lot of mixed, you know, everybody knew somebody from another part of the United States because it was always moving.
It's right here if you really want to see it.
So, what sport did you like?
How about what did you do on your honeymoon?
What sport did you like?
A funny thing happened on my honeymoon. Had my all my clothes laid out where I was going to come home from the wedding and do some chores, and then I was going to sleep. And I'd be damned if I didn't lose track of my pajamas. Oh boy!
So you went on a honeymoon with no pajamas?
Well, we had to scrape up some. We just stayed the night in a folks' house out on the farm there.
So it wasn't the time to go on big, huge, crazy trips?
Oh, no. We didn't have the money, nor it wasn't, travel wasn't so good and stuff.
Yeah. What was transportation like then? What, obviously horses, but cars were around, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Did everybody have one, or was it pretty...
Most of us had one. I could ask, if Minnie was here, I'd ask her about the Green Dragon. It was a green 37 ship.
No, a car. What was so weird about it?
Oh, the age of it, it was wore out, but we babied it along. But we used the dang car for I don't know how many years. But she and LaDonna would go places in the Green Dragon and then run out of gas, or the thing would quit on them.
So you had to rescue her on more than one occasion, I'm guessing.
Well, not too much. You see, we were married on the 1st of March, and I had to report in at 12th of March.
Oh, wow. So you took off pretty quick.
Yeah, I wasn't.
So you had a pen pal wife for a long time.
Yeah.
And what was it? Letters? How often would you write letters and that sort of thing?
Oh, when I could, I'd write a letter every day. She'd do the same, but we got so we couldn't do that either, you know.
Yeah, get busy.
Moving. We'd get a fistful of letters for a week, and then be a week and a half or two that we didn't get any in.
Get another pot. Okay, so back to Brennan's other question. How long did it take when you came? You know what, we haven't got you back from the war yet. Do you remember when you got the word that you get to come back, or that you were done with the war, or what that was like, or what you were doing?
No, we were a fill-in. We'd take the place of brigades. We were mostly communications outfit. We had our mode of transportation was the M8s. Was M8s, I believe they were eight or six wheel real light tanks. No tracks.
Brenda Lou? Why don't you grab a candy bar or something and then... Do you remember when they let you know that you could come back home to your lovely wife?
You know, that's a funny thing. They put us in, we went to, went back to Erlangen, Germany. It's where the, close to there was where the Erlangen Bridge that we were assigned all communications for that bridgehead.
What was your favorite sport?
My favorite sport? Sleeping.
No, that's not a sport.
Huh?
That's not a sport.
That's not a sport, she says. You have to have a better...
Oh, yes, it is a sport.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
Well, I always looked at it as a sport because I didn't have get too much of it.
What was your favorite sport?
Oh, I would say... Baseball, football.
Baseball is good. Yeah. I haven't tried football because I'm not big enough. I let boys play.
So you don't remember where you were at when they said you could come home? Or what you were doing? Or?
Yeah.
Sorry, we interrupted.
We were in the repo. Repo depot, they call them. Had to go through those and be reassigned, and that's when I went over there. I did that on the boat because we got there at a certain time, about 9:30, 10 o'clock, something like that, and they loaded us right on one of those the larger one of the landing crafts, and went over. And got to go off, we weren't under fire when we got off the boat, which was lucky.
So then they put you on a boat and sent you back overseas, huh?
No, they sent me into France and Belgium. And our first assignment was to close the gap that the Germans had made with the... they concentrated all their big guns and tanks and everything for this Battle of the Bulge, and they had us pretty well whipped until we got over there, and he come in from the south and chased him back into Germany. Then we kept on going, and that's where we ran into the bridge that wasn't knocked clear down on the Rhine River. And our job there was to communications again. And that was a hell of a job, really. We had to keep communications with all the troops that were trying to get across that bridgehead, and some that were in the area. And one of the, after about 10 days, the traffic kind of slowed down, and I was out walking around the west end of the bridge. And I heard the damnedest hip, 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 hoo, hoo, hip, 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 hoo. And so I come around a kind of a curve in the road there, and here come a Negro division. They were still walking in time. And
have you ever fell off a boat before?
I tried to see when I was coming home, on a Liberty ship, how much I could stand and not get seasick. And I never did get seasick.
I never
You've driven on lots of little boats. You get sick on a little boat too.
And
I got sick in the car before, that's all.
You get car sick?
Not very often. Long trips usually she saves it for, but Then do you remember, where did you meet Granny when you came back from the war?
I came to Grandpa and Grandma's. That was a funny thing. Before I got to America, we came into Boston. We were properly welcomed and everything. But for the life of me, I cannot remember the last 3 days on the boat. No, I didn't get sick, nor can I remember getting off of that damn boat at Boston. And then we went back to, and were put us in barracks and fed us, and we went, in a couple of days we all had assignments to report places in the United States.
So you weren't done when you came back? You still were part of the Army?
Oh, yeah. But wasn't too much to it.
Well, let's move on. And what was it like with four kids in your house? Not when you were little, but when you and Minnie had kids.
Well, we got along pretty good. We'd try to take a long ride on the weekend. And first we'd go to the northwest Nebraska, and then we'd go to the northeast Nebraska, and then we'd go southeast Nebraska. And most of our travels as young people and young family was in southwest Nebraska, right around here. But we'd try to divide out so we'd have something new to see each weekend.
What did we see?
We went up in northwest Nebraska and saw Toadstool Park, and I didn't realize it was up there.
I've never been to it either. I heard it's cool.
Pretty neat. It's just big, a plane with a couple rocks here and three there and four there. And
what were some of the kids' different likes when they were little, or what were some of their favorite things to do? Obviously, they were all four different kids, but they must have had some things in common.
Well, Carl was the trickster. He would give the boys, when we had it, we'd give them a quarter apiece for when they went to town on Saturday night and they could get a comic book. And Carl would, he would finagle around and never really buy a comic book. And then he got so he'd have me keep his quarter for him so he wouldn't spend it. But he would finagle George to buy the comic books and he'd read them.
That's pretty smart. Well, he'd read George's comic books, Brother George.
Instead of just paying for them?
Yeah, instead of buying them himself.
That's okay. Instead of just wasting money.
Really?
What else did they like to do?
Did you have any girls?
Oh,
girls?
I had Martha.
Aunt Marty.
Aunt Marty
and George and Tom and Carl.
Girl?
Just Marty, Aunt Marty. What'd she like to do
and
with
baby?
All those boys?
Oh,
what did Marty like to do with the boys?
She was pretty much an outdoors type. She'd play games with them. Hide in trees and stuff like that.
Who was the oldest?
George was the oldest.
George.
What'd he like to do? He seems like the scholarly type, but...
Well, he... He liked to play games with the rest of them. But he was pretty young when he left for California.
Just like his great-grandpa, maybe. Like his grandpa, I guess.
Yeah.
And then what did Tom like to do? At whatever age?
Read Carl and Tom's comic books when they were fighting over them. No.
Are you running out of energy there, producer gal? Is that what we're doing down here?
Hmm?
Are you running out of energy?
Mm-hmm.
Your sitting buns are wearing down?
I don't know.
Well, after you got all the boys and the girl off to their lives by themselves, what did you and Granny like to do? Hey, Brennan, can you have a seat?
We almost always went dancing every weekend or every Saturday or whenever there was a good dance around. We liked to dance.
What was some of your favorite dances or types or...
Music.
We always liked to. Sammy Kay was one of our favorites. Swing and Sway with Sammy Kay and Les Brown and his band of renown. He was good. But didn't get to be as, you know, big like Lombardo and Welk and stuff like that. If we'd see that some of those big bands or big orchestras were going to be in Lincoln or Omaha, we got so we'd save up and go down to dance with them.
That's cool. Well, I think we about run out of steam, Papa. Brennan, do you have any other questions while we have the camera on him? And Papa, do you have anything else that you'd like to spiel at the moment? We can always come back.
Who was your favorite? Who was the quietest?
Who was the quietest? I would guess either Martha or Tom.
What?
Either Martha or Tom were the quietest.
Who was the noisy?
I don't know. But when we'd go any place, if the kids got to arguing or fighting in the back seat, I would just let up on the gas a little bit, and they knew I was going to stop. And then the two that were fighting would have to get out and walk together from one large electric pole to another one. And generally, when I'd look in the mirror after I'd drive down to the second post, They'd be talking and yak, 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 and be having a great time.
That's a good idea. Warm weather, cold weather, didn't matter, huh?
No, sir. The colder the dead, the quicker they'd die.
That's a good idea. Do you understand what he said? Yeah. They're fighting in the back seat. Throw them out and make them walk.
Where?
On the road. They'd walk on the road.
If we'd be going someplace and they're arguments and stuff would be getting too noisy in the back seat, I would tell them. Finally I just got so I'd let up on the gas, and that's all it took.
What kind of car did you have when you had all the kids? Obviously you had a pretty good sized something, rather.
Well, we had a 59 station wagon. One of the newer types of bodies at that time, I think. And we'd go on fishing outings and
any other impossible questions? And don't ask him the color of milk. We know that.
What's the color of milk?
Well, she knows pretty much, because she said when we were discussing it before I started taping, she said there was strawberry colored milk.
Yeah,
and she don't know it, but that's colostrum.
There is strawberry colored milk.
Oh, Pepto-Bismol?
No.
No.
Okay. And when I'd milk, the kids didn't like to milk cows either. But I would had some cows I could do this with. I could sit there and squirt a steady stream, and cats would start licking and just sit there and licking. As long as I keep the stream steady, well, they'd be happy.
Feeding the cats right off the cow. Did you get that?
What? He's spraying it like this.
Yep.
Into their mouth.
Yep.
Like this.
Yep. Well, thank you, Papa.
Oh, I forgot a lot of it.
Well, we might come back again sometime. You got a hug to Papa, and then we'll go?
We tangled up in the wire, so yeah. Break them.
Oh, you can get the mic off. You gotta squeeze the little thingy.
Thank you. That was fun to
You're
perform for you and have you ask questions.
Oh my God.
Let me loosen it up. There you go.
How do I do?
You just turn. It's rolling. You can shoot.
Shoot.
It's rolling. It's going. I'll put it on autofocus for you so it'll focus for you. Show everybody the room. There's Brenna's candy. Papa's candy.
Here is my dad.
Just a little bit, or it's going to be a big blur. About right there would be about right. Make some good pictures. I bet you.
Focus.
Spin a circle.
What? Over. And. Focus.
I'll put it back on, don't worry about it.
Okay. Boy. Now, trying to get in Papa's closet. See Papa's closet?
Putting her right. Oh, did you get a picture of Papa's? Deal there.
Light bulbs are those.
Down here?
Yeah, they're not night lights.
Bright? I don't know what they are.
They must be halogen.
Yeah, maybe they are.
They don't seem to warm up.
Maybe it's just a little. Maybe it's a little fluorescent? Is that? No. It could be a little fluorescent too. I don't know.
They are changing.
You're going around in circles, Sally. You're rolling. Is the green light on in there, Brent?
What?
The green light on in there?
Yeah.
Okay, that means you're rolling. Well, what's for dinner today?
For dinner? I don't really know. Is it dinner time?
Oh, no, I don't think quite yet. Is it 10 even yet? 10:30?
10:14, I don't know.
Papa's back. Okay. Yeah. Little Steven Spielberg over there. Yes, your nurse did seem to be very nice. Shooting the ceiling.